डियर लर्नर्स फ्रेंड्स वी डिस्कस द लिटरेचर रिव्यू वी वर डिस्कसिंग द प्रोसेस ऑफ लिटरेचर रिव्यू प्लानिंग एंड आफ्टर दैट प्रोसेसिंग इन द प्रोसेस इन द सर्च स्टेप ऑफ द प्रोसेस वी यूज कीवर्ड्स वी यूज बूलियन सर्च ऑपरेटर्स फॉर इफेक्टिव सर्चिंग बट व्हाट आर द की फीचर्स of literature review. First thing is the size of the literature review. Size in the sense that what should be the length and breadth of the topic to be covered? What are the length and breadth of the content to be compiled, to be collected? It depends on subject, type of research, scope of the research, and level of the research. We cannot expect a huge literature review from the PG dissertation work. Can you expect? No. So we will have to keep the length and breadth defined. Otherwise, it is the ocean of knowledge. Each and every topic is an ocean of knowledge. You can never be PhD of an entire subject. You can be a PhD of a particular topic maybe. Because each and every topic is an ocean of knowledge. And the proper choice and effective literature review methodology may allow you to swim across that ocean. Otherwise, your literature review will sink and the quality of your research work will go down. The next is quality. Yes, the next feature is quality. Search the quality material. Search, refer the quality journals. Refer the quality publishers, quality books. Because we have already mentioned, wrong methods cannot lead to the right research. Substandard articles, if you will refer, you cannot expect a good research from the substandard articles if you are referring. So, refer the good quality articles. It is utmost important because the quality articles can only lead to the reproducible results. So, you must rely on the quality. Otherwise, if you will refer a wrong article, substandard article, you will follow it, you will try to replicate the results of the research, and what will happen? You will lose your time, you will lose your money, you will lose your resources and all the efforts. So, rely on the quality journals, articles, books and other resources, and that must be discussed properly in the planning stage along with your team members or with your supervisor or mentor. Now next feature is versatility. Versatility means your literature review must contain a good mix of variety of sources like review article, research article, news, blogs, patents, meta-analysis, regulatory guidelines, historical articles, studies, geographical distribution of compiled studies, etc. The last point, you might have got each and every point, but I would like to explain the last thing. Geographical distribution of the compilation result. What does it mean? When I am working on a issue, say for example, or a topic, I found an article, a review article, from a Chinese author, in which all the cross references were from Chinese authors only. I took that thing and pasted the thing, or I just followed that thing. I'm not saying pasted. I followed it. What I did, that I limited myself to only to that particular domain, to particular geographical area of Chinese authors only. I should refer to the different authors of different geographical locations. I should also refer to the authors from the Europe, from Africa, from North America, from South America. It will help you to study and review the topic in unbiased form. However, it may be the need of the subject of time, sometimes when you are focusing on a very, very focused or very, very constricted topic, then it might be case. But I don't think so. There is any topic in which we cannot practice this rule. This will enrich the quality, enrich the understanding of our self about our field of research. Next property is up to date or currentness. You must collect the latest references, at least last 5 to 10 years references must be there. The up to dateness is very important, because up to the end of writing of the paper, up to writing of the thesis, it must be up to date. So that's why literature review is an ongoing process till the thesis is bound. Because you started writing the thesis in year 2017 last, you finished the literature review in 2017, and you could submit the thesis in 2019. So your references are only before 2016 or 17, maybe very few references from 2017. So what is lacking there? The 2018 and 19 references are not there. It might be an objectionable issue. Because the reviewer will see that it is coming before him or her at the 2019. So the current literature must be there. Now, another property, another feature is, do not skip historical or pioneer studies in the field of research. Though in one hand I am saying that only the current literature should be cited, but we must not avoid the pioneer study. Say for example, if I am saying about the H index, if I am referring to the H index, I am criticizing the H index, can I skip the paper of Hertz of year 2005, that pioneer paper, pioneer reference? I cannot skip that reference. I cannot skip citing that reference. So always remember that you must cite the pioneer articles, pioneer studies, but don't put the overdose of the older references. Sometimes we feel trickly, we feel that we will fill up the things from an older article. You got a review article of 1998, which was very relevant to you, and then you put all the cross references, which was from way back to 1946, 56 to 66, and it ended up to 70 or 80 maybe. So what you are doing in year 2019, you are stopping your literature up to 1980 and 90. It is very bad. It is not at all acceptable. Next feature is completeness. Complete with the search, complete the literature review with all the aspects with respect to the topics, subtopics, allied topics, etc. with due focus. Be critical. Include the studies which may not favor your tentative hypothesis also. You must be self-critical. You have planned a thing, you have hypothesized, you are trying to hypothesize a thing. So you must not skip. You are collecting the supporting evidence, but which you are seeing as against your hypothesis or contradictory or controversial, don't skip them. It will be an unbiased ground of the literature review. And last but not the least, again and again I am saying, discuss with your supervisor, mentor and other team members or collaborators for any doubt or help. It is very important to have a good tuning with the supervisor and the scholar or the team members. Next is, ask for help. If nothing is working, don't hesitate. Don't hesitate in asking for help. Ask for help from authors, co-authors. Search their email IDs. Ask them for the full text. Most of the times, researchers provide the full text by replying the mail. If it is not working, ask for help from the other friends, colleagues, and researchers who have got the access to those journals in which that article is there. Next, you can go to social media for asking the help. The social media platform like LinkedIn or some Facebook pages or Facebook groups in which you can share your request, and the many persons are there to help you out. Other platforms like ResearchGate are there. Like the Facebook page, you can say ResearchGate is a community of researchers. No? We have discussed ResearchGate. So you can get also from there. Dear learners, let me summarize this section for you. What are the key features of literature review? The first feature is literature review size. The size must be optimum on the basis of subject, topic of research, nature of research, and level of research. Then quality. Always the quality of sources must be good. Versatility. You must have a good mix of all kinds of sources, whether it is review, research, patent, news, blog, depending upon your field. Your references. You must cite. You must cover the up-to-date literature. But you must not also skip the pioneer studies. Your literature review must be complete. It must be critical. You should not avoid the contradictory or the studies which are not favoring to you. And then you should not be afraid of asking for help even if something is not working. We will be covering the other aspects of processing of literature review in the next section.